Welcome you all in second session of your non-conventional machining process. Am I audible to you? If yes, please leave message in chat box, yes or no. Audible to you? Please leave a message. Jasmine, please leave a message in chat box. If am I audible to you? Okay, thank you, Jasmine. Now I will start this session. Today we will discuss about electrochemical machining process. In last session we were discuss about laser beam machining process, electrical discharge machining process, and two more methods. So today we will discuss about this electrochemical machining process. Its short form is ECM. In this session, we will discuss about principle of ECM, then construction of ECM, working of ECM, applications, advantages, disadvantages, and properties of electrolyte, which electrolyte is suitable for the method. These are the contents of the today's session. Now, firstly, we will discuss principle of electrochemical machining process. What is the principle? Electrochemical machining process is basically, it is based on the principle of reverse electroplating. It is exactly opposite to your electroplating process. Now, before going to the electrochemical machining process, we will discuss about electroplating process. Now, this electroplating process is also called as a electro deposition process. Means deposition of one metal over the another metal. There are various applications are available. I think electroplating, what is electroplating? That is already known to you, which is studied in your chemistry. So firstly, definition of electroplating is the process that uses an electric current to reduce dissolved metal cations so that they form a thin coherent metal coating on an electrode. Now you can see this figure, basic figure of your electroplating. Now we will take an example of a gold plating. Now there are two electrodes. Take an example of a gold plating. There are two electrodes. First electrode is connected to this input supply battery. DC current is supplied. Negative terminal, that is known as a cathode. First electrode is connected to the negative terminal and second electrode is connected to the positive terminal of an input supply, that is called as a anode. Now this system is completely immersed into this solution, which is known as a electrolyte. When the circuit is completed, electric current will start flowing from anode to cathode. Now when we are taking example of a gold plating, now your gold is connected to the positive terminal, which is anode, and jewelry is connected to the negative terminal, where we have to do the plating of gold over the workpiece. Workpiece is your jewelry. So when the electric current will start flowing from anode to cathode, oxidization of a gold will start takes place, and this oxidized ions will dissolve into this electrolyte. Positive ions are dissolved into the electrolyte, and which is reduced or attracted towards the negative terminal, which is your cathode, and deposited over your this workpiece, which is jewelry. So Electroplating is done by this gold over your workpiece, that is your jewelry. This is the basic example of a electroplating. This is known as a electroplating. Now we will see the next slide. In your next slide, we will discuss about what is the basic requirement or basics of your electrochemical machining process and how this machining process is carried out. Now, as we know, there are different machining processes are available: mechanical process, electrical process, electrochemical process, electromechanical process. But in case of your electrochemical machining process, we are using electrochemical machining process to remove the material. In case of your electroplating, material is deposited on your workpiece, but in case of your electrochemical machining process, material is removing by using electrochemical action. This is your basic difference between plating and electrochemical machining process. So this electrochemical machining process is used for mass production purpose, and where we are using this electrochemical machining process, we are using this electrochemical machining processes for extremely harder material, which cannot be machined by using conventional machining process. Machining is not possible by using conventional machining process. Is done by using your electrochemical machining process. So again, next parameter, but there is some limitation of using this electrochemical machining process. Hello, am I audible to all? Hello, please leave a message. Tanuja, you said you didn't hear my voice. Okay. Up to which point? Okay, thank you Shubham. Now your next point is, there is a disadvantage of using this electrochemical machining process. What is the disadvantage of using this electrochemical machining process? This process is only suitable for electrically conductive materials. This is the disadvantage. Then there are various advantages are also available in your, by using this electrochemical machining process, we can manufacture small shapes, different complex shape, intricate shapes can be manufactured by using electrochemical machining process, which is not possible by using your conventional machining process. And this process is also suitable for external and internal geometry of a part. This is the basic information of your electrochemical machining process. Now we will discuss about elements of your electrochemical machining process in next slide. Now see this figure. There are lots of elements which is involved into the electrochemical machining process. Is this visible to you? First element of your electrochemical machining process is DC power supply. DC power supply. Second element is your tool. Now tool, it is denoted by negative sign. Now negative sign, why it is denoted by negative sign? Because tool is connected to the negative terminal of a input DC power supply. Then next element is your workpiece. Third element is your workpiece. Workpiece is denoted by positive sign, so it is connected to the positive terminal of a DC power supply. Wait a minute. Hello, am I audible to you, Divya? Hello, Divya. You said आवाज येत नाहीये मॅम तुमचा. आवाज येतोय का दिव्या आता? If yes, please leave message in chat box, yes or no, to continue the session. Okay, thank you Ashwin. Now I will continue this session. input supply is connected to the positive terminal and negative terminal in terms of a tool and workpiece. This workpiece is placed into the container. This is your container. Inside the container, workpiece is placed. Then next element, major element of your electrochemical machining process is this circulation system, which plays important role. So first element of your circulation system is the motor, which is connected to this pump, which provides the input electrical supply to this pump to supply electrolyte from reservoir to the workplace of your workpiece. So electrolyte is stored into the reservoir. Next, pump is connected to this filter. If there are some impurity which is coming from the electrolyte, which is separated by using the filter, so filter is provided for filtering purpose. The next element is through the pipe, this electrolyte is supplied to this position where the machining process is carried out. Okay, continuous supply of your electrolyte is done over here. Next element is your servo motor. This servo motor plays important role. This servo motor is connected to the tool. You can see from here, the servo motor is connected to the negative means tool. Main function of using this servo motor is to provide the downward motion to carry out the machining action. When the machining will take place at this location, then the material is removed, then constant tool feed is done with the help of the servo motor in this machining process. So now this is the construction of your electrochemical machining process. Now next we will discuss about working, how this process will carry out. Now input source DC power supply, direct current will pass to the positive terminal workpiece to your this system, and ions will start flowing from positive to negative and negative to positive. Positive to negative means from workpiece to tool, and negative ions will start flowing from tool to workpiece. Continuous flow will observe due to input supply, which is given by DC power source. So its parameters are around 5 to 40,000 ampere, and voltage supplied is around 30 volt. The gap which is provided between this tool and the workpiece to carry out the electrochemical reaction, which is around 0.05 mm to 0.07 mm to carry out this process. Then the main function is carried out by using this circulation system. While electrochemical reaction will take place at this location, main function of an electrolyte is to complete this circuit. Then electrochemical reaction will take place at this location, and this flow of electrons, ions from positive to negative and negative to positive is break due to continuous strong flow of electrolyte by using circulation system, and material is removed in the form of a small particle. Then you can observe this flow of electrolyte from pump to filter, filter to center of your tool, and again it is flowing from this workpiece to the direct to the audible. Now this is the working of your electrochemical machining process. Working is completed. Now we will move to the next point, which is parameter which plays important role in case of your electrochemical machining process. Okay, before going to the parameters, how the chemical reaction will take place at working position, we will discuss in details. This is the following chemical reaction takes place at machining. Then we are using electrolyte, sodium chloride plus H2O. Then for machining of a pure iron, we are using this electrolyte. So NaCl, sodium chloride, is dissociated into sodium ion and fluorine ion. H2O is dissociated into H plus hydrogen ions plus OH ions. Then this electrolyte process is carried out. Chemical reaction will take place at this point. In this electrolysis process, 2H ions are combined to the two electrons will form hydrogen. And how the material remove process will carried out? During electrolysis, two ions of sodium combines with the two OH ions will form two NaOH. Then Fe plus 2Cl will form FeCl2. And last chemical reaction represents output of your process. 2NaOH plus FeCl2 will give you 2NaCl plus FeOH2. This is the chemical reaction which is expressed at the machining process, at the position of your machining. Next parameter is your electrochemical machining process. What are the important parameters in case of your electrochemical machining process? As I discussed in working, voltage which is required, it is around 4 to 30 volts, then current 50 to 40 thousand ampere. Material remove rate is larger in this case as compared to the other machining process, other non-conventional machining process. It is around 1600 meter cube per minute. Surface finish is also better in this process. So 0.1 to 2.5 micrometer. Then the gap which is provided between tool and the workpiece is around 0.025 to 0.75 mm. Then next point is your properties of an electrolyte. Before going to the properties, what is the main function of using your electrolyte? We will discuss in details. Main function of an electrolyte is to carry out the electrochemical reaction or to complete the circuit. Electrolyte is necessary. After completion of a electrochemical reaction or machining process, material is removed in the form of a small particle. This material should be carried away from the working position to the reservoir. So we are using this electrolyte to remove the material from cutting region by pressure. Pressure which is supplied to this electrolyte is around velocity of this flow velocity of your electrolyte is around 30 to 60 meter per second. Then carry again, third function of your electrolyte is to carry away the heat which is generated at the working position. These are the three main functions of your electrolyte. Now we will discuss what are the important properties of electrolyte. First property, high thermal conductivity and electrical conductivity. It should be high thermal conductive and electrical conductivity. Low viscosity. Low viscosity, cheap, and it should be easily available. Electrolyte, it should be easily available. It should be non-corrosive and non-toxic. And fifth parameter is chemically stable at process temperature. These are the basic properties which is required to select your electrolyte. Then what are the advantages of electrochemical machining process? First advantage is complex. As we discussed in the introduction, small intricate shapes, complex shapes can be manufactured. So this ECM process is useful for complex, concave, curvature. Components can be manufactured easily by using concave tool. Second, tool wear is also zero in this case. So we can use this tool, reuse this tool in different applications or producing infinite number of components. Third parameter, no direct contact between tool and the workpiece. So there are no force and residual stresses will induce into the tool and the workpiece. Fourth parameter, the surface finish produced is excellent by using this process, means we can achieve the accuracy and precision by using ECM. Fifth is less heat is generated and what are the disadvantages. There are three disadvantages. As we discussed in introduction, this process is suitable for only conductive materials. It is not suitable for all type of a material. Second parameter, high specific energy consumption to remove the larger amount of material is required. And third parameter, it cannot be used for softer material. It is used for extremely harder material, machining of extremely harder material. Now we will discuss about applications where we can use this electrochemical machining process. First, drilling jet engine turbine blades. Then second application is multiple hole drilling. Then machining steam turbine blades within closed limits. Micro machining process. And fifth is profiling and countering. These are the different applications of electrochemical machining process.